I train Monday through Saturday, but I take off on Sundays. I don't have a fixed plan in terms of my practice. It depends on my condition and needs, but I'm practicing 4 to 5 hours each day.
The biggest challenge for her is that she needs to cope with her injuries. She needs to avoid any more injuries this year and keep her body and mind strong to get herself ready for competitions. As her husband and also her coach, I try to take care of her in almost every way. Not just in giving her instructions on how to play tennis, but also helping her with a lot of things in our daily lives. My workload is, of course, very heavy, but we're a couple. I enjoy working with her.
You really need to give up a lot if you want to be a professional tennis player.
You do have a reputation for showing your feelings when you're on court. Why is it that when you're there, the emotions just overtake and you've got to vent?
I think I reveal it naturally on court. The best scene of venting emotions is the cheering yell for yourself when you gain 1 point. It's natural to reveal feelings on the court, but it's different for me in daily life. I'm very calm in life, but you're allowed to have so much passion on the court, and I enjoy this feeling very much.
I understand that you do have a particular quirk. You like to carry around a bottle of your bone fragments.
My ankle, left ankle, yeah. Have the 2 bone skin then. This is from the surgery.
I feel this is a part from my body. Even though the injuries made my world ranking plunge, it also makes me grow up a lot and makes me cherish the feeling of being able to run around freely on the court. And it makes me cherish every second of every day. So this little bottle is very meaningful for me.
I'm also interested in getting a bit of an insight into what life is like for players on the WTA Tour. You're shunted from country to country and all of your concentration has to be on the game. Does it ever feel sort of unreal?
Initially, I wasn't used to it. Before in China, there were very few matches to play. You played only 4 or 5 matches a year. Only when you were on the national team, you were given a lot of chances to go play matches abroad. So when it jumps from 4 or 5 matches to 20 or 30 matches a year, it feels like a dream. Every day when you wake up, it's all about the match. At first, it was very boring, not much fun.
Do you think that these tours are particularly hard on young players?
It might be easier to get accustomed to the schedule if you have the chance to play in more matches. But when I was in my teens, I didn't have the chance to play in many matches. At the beginning, I wasn't used to it. But now it's easier and more fun. Also, you get to meet a lot of players and become friends with those on the tour. I'm glad to have had such an experience and meet friends from all over the world, getting to know them.
Are there rivalries between the players on the tour?
Sure, there are rivalries. for each match always has a winner and a loser. I think on the court, people are rivals given the competition, but away from it, we're all young people. We talk about clothes, fashion, where to go shopping. So I think off the court, we're all friends with good relationships.
When you're on the tour, I guess that there would have to be some downtime where you can just, you know, kick back and do whatever you like. How do you switch off from the game when you're still on the tour?
When I don't have a match, I'd go shopping. Or during breaks, I'll choose to listen to music and watch movies to relax. The matches are already very tiring, so I wouldn't want to go out.
Your coach now certainly likes you rather a lot. You're married to him. How did love blossom between the two of you?